In this video, I'm going to show you how you can do the top view of the shaft guide. So I've already got the front view drawn out here. I am missing a few things in that front view. We still need to get some hidden lines and center lines, and actually one visible line still needed in that front view. But we got to get it drawn out in other views, especially the top view, before we can get to that. So the first thing that I'm going to do is go ahead and set my visible layer current. Now there's several ways that we could approach this top view, but if I look in the book, I can see that the overall width is 101.6 and the overall depth is 50.8. So I think what I'm going to do is just draw the footprint up there with a rectangle. I'll follow the directions. It says to begin the upper left corner right up here. So I'll just snap to that corner. I'm going to type 101.6, press tab, and then I'll type in the 50.8 and press enter. So I just pulled the mouse in the direction I wanted to go, which was kind of in this lower, what would you call that, like the southeast quadrant. And went ahead and drew that. Now I do, when I draw that rectangle, it comes in as one piece. So all those lines are connected into one long line. So I do need to explode it. I'm going to click on the explode command. I had it selected, so it exploded it into four separate lines, which is what I need it to do. Press escape to deselect those lines. Now I'm going to do my offset command. So I will click on offset. I need this back line to come down. If I look in the book, the depth of that is 12.7. So before I click on anything, I haven't clicked anywhere, I haven't typed anything, I just started the command, let go of my mouse. I'm going to type in 12.7. Press enter, and now it knows that's the new offset distance. It's going to make a copy of this line at a distance of 12.7. So I'll click on that back line. You could go up or down. We want to go down, so we're going into the part. I'm going to click one more time. I'm done with the offset command, so I'll press enter at this point. Looks good. Now, what I see here is when you look at this sketch, there's actually an angled line that goes right here. And it tells me that that angled line is at 45 degrees. It's taking it from this vertical line going down, and it tells me it's 45 degrees in that direction. That angled line, I'll do a line command here. It starts right at this corner of my new offset that I just did. So it's coming from that 90 that's already there. It's going an additional 45. But the way AutoCAD calculates lines is it always comes from angle zero. So we have zero plus 90, then we need to add an additional 45, which will actually make it 135 if you do the math. When I'm drawing this line, the length doesn't really matter. It could be long, it could be short. The only thing that really matters is that it's 135 degrees. I can always extend it, I can always trim it. So I'm just going to leave it, kind of pull it out in this direction here. I'm going to press tab to get out of the length. That'll take me to the angle, and I will type 135, enter, and it just drew my line for me. So I'll enter again just to end that line command. And now I'll just come in here and trim. Click here, click here, click here. That looks good. So this actually does project down to be a visible line in this front view here. So let's go ahead and do that before we forget about it. So this corner projects straight down. I kind of acquired that point. We'll go to intersection and perpendicular, and that's good. That's perfect. So we do need that visible corner right here showing in that front view. Now what we're going to do is we'll come up to that top view, and we will fillet this corner. You see how it's round right there? It's got a radius of 19, and then it has a circle. They're concentric. They share the same center point, but that one has a diameter of 19. So we'll do first the fillet command. It's right up here. Click there. Now remember, right when we start the fillet command, it's easy to kind of jump ahead and want to get going on this one, but we have to stop and tell it what we want our radius to be. So we're going to type R, enter, because R is the capital letter and the blue letter in the word radius. You could also click on the word radius right here, or you could also press the down arrow on your keyboard until you get to radius. However you get there, three ways to do it. no right or wrong way. Press enter. So our radius here is going to be 19. Press enter. Now we can click on these two lines and it just rounds it out for us. It's a perfect 19. We're going to draw a circle diameter. We will hover next to this arc so we can see that center mark. Oh snap. And this one has a diameter of 19. So remember, they both say 19, but one is a radius and one is a diameter, two very different sizes. So this looks good. Let's go ahead and project that down so we get it in the front view. I like to do them kind of as we go. We'll draw a line here. We'll just acquire this point from that quadrant straight down. Make sure you have intersect, perpendicular, oh snap one. Press enter. Press enter to repeat your last command. Acquire it, bring it down and down. Looks good. Let's go ahead and do our center. Same thing. Bring it straight from the center here. We're going to bring it here and here. Now our front view is done. The only thing we're going to have to do is at the end, remember we use that lengthen command to make those center lines longer. This looks good. Now that I've got center set current, I'll go ahead and do my dimension pull down, center mark. We'll click on the largest. We're going to do center mark again. We'll click on the circle. So we're going to do one for the arc, one for the circle. The reason I'm doing that is we really don't, it has to extend out to where the arc is, where that fillet is, but it does not have to center, or I'm sorry, extend all the way out past this one. It really only has to go past the circle. So it's a little tricky there, but we're actually going to have a shorter one that just goes past the circle here and goes past the arc of the fillet there. That's why I have two on top of each other. Once we get to the end of this project, you remember how we did the sweep command or the overkill command? I say sweep because it looks like a broom, but it's called the overkill command. And that'll clean up lines on top of each other. All right, this looks good. Now let's go ahead and project the circles from this view. We're going to project all of that up into the top view. So let's do a line. We'll acquire this point. We've already got the center line layer current. May as well go do it. Looks good. Change it over to hidden. We're going to do a hidden line here. Where that hole is, I'm just pressing enter to repeat the command, enter to end the command, enter to repeat the command. I don't know if I've mentioned it before, but the space bar on your keyboard is also enter. That's actually what I'm using. All right, this looks good. So we've got this hole being drilled through the top here. We're going to wait to do this. Well, we could do it now. On that side view, we're going to see where this right here, if you look at it, it projects out a certain distance. So we could go ahead and do that now. It tells us that that distance that it projects out is 25.4 from the back. So let's go ahead and offset 25.4, enter, take that back line out, 25.4, set our visible layer current. And we'll do a line from the quadrant here to here. From the quadrant, be careful what you're picking up. You don't want to pick up the end point of anything. From here to here, that looks good. Now we can come in here and trim. All right. That mostly looks good. I'm going to actually trim this out. We're going to come deal with this in just a second. Now, these lines, I could have done that first. Those lines, let's go ahead and extend those down. So it's buried in with trim is extend. We'll just click on these. They'll extend down to the next thing they see. So that looks great. We do have a couple of more things, little tricky things that you might not see in this top view, but I do want to point it out. We've got our visible layer current. I want to point out, this right here is the quadrant, right? We know that this is the quadrant of the circle, that corner of the circle. But look, this line came up and touched the tangent. So it comes in a little bit. Do you see how there's two different locations there? We need to actually show that in the top view. So we're gonna take it from the endpoint of that line that we snapped up to quadrant. Let's see what we can do. There's several ways we could approach this. It's just saying that this line right here comes out to that edge. We're just trying to define that edge right there. So let's go ahead and extend there. This was just a construction line to get me there. I'm gonna delete that. See how it comes in a little. It looks weird, but that's really how it would actually look on that object. Let's do it again on this one. We're gonna go from the endpoint. This again will just be a little construction line, just trying to figure out how far this line comes in. We will extend to there. All right, are we done? Almost. One more tricky thing. The bottom edge of this is still there. Even though we don't see it from the top, it still is a hard edge underneath there. So we do need to draw from our new endpoints a hidden line. All right, that looks good. So we've accounted for the circle that's being cut through here, all the way through. We've got our hidden line here. We've got the cylinder that sticks out. We drew that over here, drew these lines up to the tangent. We've got our circle. That circle projects down, hidden, center, hidden. And we've got this corner of that angle projects straight down as well. All right, this looks good. So next up is our side view, and then we are done with this project.